Okay, we're gonna do a quick three thing update. Number one is Papa's old shed, which we've gotten torn down. Sam came over yesterday and got the tin roofing he wanted, and he still needs to get some wood off the pile, and then he's gonna come out and burn this. And I have a little issue here. Well, it's really not an issue. I just need to know how to get it moved. You remember there was that table that was sitting here that had the sink in it? And when the wall came down, that got snapped off, and they just went ahead and just put the spigot right there to stick up out of the ground. And this is the back of the apartment. And oh, by the way, this is Toby. This is my new friend, and he's having issues right now. He has what's called Schnauzer bumps, and it's just genetic thing. And this is about as much as I can get shaved. Say hello. This is about as much as I can get shaved. I have to be very careful because he will get me. And he's just got these bumps all over him. It kind of looks like acne. And I know, right? I would show you, but I'm in fear of my hand. Well, anyway, this is Toby, and we're going to be doing cold tar baths with, well, basically it's going to be a switch every other day between T-Gel and Denorex shampoo, and a good healthy diet, heavy in omega-3, which is basically he's going to be eating sardines. And this will clear up. First, I thought it was some kind of a wheat or grass problem, but it is Schnauzer bumps. I'm trying to get in here so you can see them. It's all over him. See, it kind of looks like acne. And he will nail me. He hasn't bitten me yet, but it's coming. I keep it up. All right, off the dock. Anyway, that's Mr. Toby. Okay, what I was trying to get at was, as you can see, there's that spigot that's sticking up right there, and it's got to be going straight over here, because as you can see through this grapefruit tree and all these screens that I got to rescreen once I get the house painted, that, I don't know if you can see it, right, where's my finger, right there, that's the water going into, or coming out of, hey sweetie, that bathroom I've got to tear down in that apartment. So if somebody can tell me outside of a divining rod how to figure out where this is, I would greatly appreciate it. Common sense says it's a straight shot, but as I've been prodding around, it goes off in angles like this. I've never seen anything like it, but you know, again, this is my grandfather. I need to finish that bird bath, but anyway. So that's that. Help me with the water issue, and let's get an update real quick on the house. Toby! Love this dog. Okay, all I gotta do is paint this side of the house. That's it. The other side has been painted. Oh, there he is. Very good. Let me just say one other thing about this dog. He is such a fast learner. I've got him trained that he waits for me to walk through the door, and before he walks through, and when I tell him to go to place, which is his crate, like let's say somebody came over, and or I just needed him out from underfoot, and I say place, he goes straight to his place, and he stays there until I tell him to break. I say, Toby, break, and he comes right out. I love this dog. I love him. Then just a little bit more training with the Tyler Mutto, and he should be really, really good. You can look up Tyler Mutto, M-U-T-T-O, on YouTube. All right, getting back to the house. I didn't mean to drag this out. Is I ran into a snag, and the snag is, well, yeah, this paint comes right off and whatnot. Yeah, that's perfect, right? That sounds so great. I mean, just want to break out the champagne and cigars, but it's lead, people. That is lead. And I I can't get it off safely. So, let me get my beast. There he is. Good boy. Yep. Hey, Mr. Toby. Come here. I did manage to get this painted. I think the color is fine. That's not the problem. It's just that I think it's going to be a little too top heavy if I do put the toffee crunch up there. So I'll go around and show you what I'm talking about. But since I couldn't get the lead paint off, I'm not going to pay. With the surgery coming up on the 23rd, I just can't afford it. And I thought maybe just switching the wood back around, but that would entail having to take off the eaves drip. So I just had to do the best I could. And I think that it being mostly behind the gutters, it's 6 inches, 5.5, 6 inches, I think we'll be fine. But the question is, excuse me, over here. Thank you. The problem I'm running into is this paint right here. This is what I picked out, and that's the toffee crunch, right? But then so is this. See the difference? See how dark and rich that is compared to that caramel look? Well, here's the problem. That is semi-gloss or matte. I think it's semi-gloss. Yeah, and as you can see, you can tell down there how glossy it is. The way that it just reflects the light, it makes it look a different color, and it's not as rich like this. So I thought it was going to be, oh shit, I can't take this paint back. But actually, if I just use the rest of the paint to do the first coat, when I do the second coat, I can just put flat on there. It'll be fine. So at any rate, this is the color. I just think it's going to be too heavy, make the top of the house too heavy if I put those two colors. But then if I step back, the middle kind of breaks that up. I don't know. So I'm just going to need some help here with decisions. So if you guys could help me, I'd appreciate it. Let me find my dog. Okay. I had to go retrieve my dog. Okay, yeah, I'm not gonna paint this. I know you guys thought I should have paint or should think I could paint this, but this has got to be replaced, so no painting. I don't know, I'm just getting a little concerned about this coloring. So let's take a look over here. I don't know. I don't know if it'll be too top heavy or if that will be just fine. I don't know. And I don't know. I really need some guidance here from my friends, so. Let me try to get it. Sorry about the sun in your eyes, but I'm trying. There we go. If you think that'll look fine, let me know. I mean, after all, nobody's here but me. But still, you got to represent. See how that is real glossy up there? When I came out after painting and said, man, it's taking that paint forever to dry. And then I realized, oh, man, that's not the problem. Yeah. All right, I'm going to quit rambling. Thanks for watching.